Hey, Roy, where's the duck?
It's down at maintenance. The thermostat's on the fritz. He's trying to get somebody to
wait,
fix
this.
It.
I'm getting worse. I'm going to pass out.
Do we dinner tonight?
Yeah. Yeah, this all started right after I finished eating.
You think it's gas?
Could be. That stuffed cabbage packs a mean crunch.
All right, give me a break, guys. I'm dying here, okay?
Okay, get up on the table.
Look, I'm going to go find the doc. And Carter, don't try anything funny, huh? Preston Bates will show you what real pain is.
Lousy food probably poisoned me.
Hey, you know how it is, man. We get all the rotten apples.
I would laugh, but this is a prison. It's not.
Listen, man, you want some water?
Yeah, that would be great. My mouth's real dry.
Man, I caught you on that.
On what?
Bringing forth a witness is a waste of your time.
Oh, this better be good.
Does the name Gainey Muldoor ring a bell?
Yeah, he hasn't been at work all day. I've had every cop in the precinct out looking for him.
Oh, next time try a journalist.
Are you saying that you...
I'm not saying anything. I'll let the facts speak for me, or in this case, Mr. Muldoor himself.
Yeah, well, he's only going to confirm what we already suspect. Is there a Mr. Muldoor out here?
The police are wrong. When you ask Mr. Muldoor, you'll see that for yourself.
I'm Gainey Muldoor.
Lieutenant Bowman, I'd like to ask you a few questions. Come in, please.
Any way I can cooperate?
Hi, Gainey.
How you doing?
You can send our friend in now. Yeah, I'm right next door. How's your memory?
Well, I never forget a face.
Good. Very good. Would you step over to the window, please? Did that man rent a van from you last night, Mr. Muldoor?
Turned her against me. She listens to him now.
What are you talking about?
Liza in Kentucky. I told you about them last night.
No, you didn't. You told me that you were onto them, but that you needed proof. I have no idea what that means.
They're having an affair.
What makes you think that?
I don't think it. I know it. And don't give me that look. I've tried to be fair. When I caught them together in the hangar, I decided to look the other way until I found something conclusive. Well, now I have. Last night confirmed my suspicions.
Last night?
I followed Liza to Hunts Lake. She met Kentucky there. We spent the night together.
Ah, then you lied. You really went up there to spy on Liza in Kentucky.
Victoria, will you listen to me? They're trying to push me out. They're working together. I've got to claim it.
Don't say that. Can't you see what it's doing to you?
No one was supposed to be hurt in that explosion, Victoria. I had it all worked out.
No, you didn't. There never should have been an explosion. I'm afraid for you.
Don't be. I love you. And I won't take a risk like that again.
I love you too, but... I don't mean to be so hard on you, but I only want to help.
Do you really
want
to help?
Of course.
Then help me destroy Kentucky's credibility. Get me something that I can use against Kentucky with Liza. She'll come back. I know it.
Mm-hmm.
No, that's not the guy.
Are you sure?
Yeah, positive.
Well, it's easy to make a mistake. These quick identifications, they can be tricky. Would you like more time?
No, I don't need it. No, this guy is all wrong. Besides, he's a nervous wreck.
Yeah, well, maybe that's because we have his signature on the rental receipt.
Lieutenant, the guy that I rented the van to was cool, like a yellow squash.
A yellow squash?
Yeah, he was blonde.
Blonde?
Mm-hmm. No, that guy in there doesn't look anything like him. That is one sorry looking fella.
Well, not for long. Your statement's gonna put a very big smile on his face.
Thank you, Mr. Muldoor. We'll call you again if we need to see you.
Okay, sure thing.
Bye, Gainey.
Bye.
Go tell him, Lieutenant. I want to see him smile again.
Not so fast.
But Muldoor just cleared Cagney.
And I'm glad. I really am. But that doesn't mean that Cagney is off the hook.
Cagney did not steal that payroll. Lloyd knows it, and so do I.
The only thing you know is that Cagney didn't rent that van. But he did pick up the money. We have eyewitnesses to prove it.
So? Cagney told you himself that he picked it up, but then he was wrong.
Yeah, I know. By a blonde guy who rented a van.
Try finding him, and you might have your answer.
Find him? Oh, that's a good one.
I found Muldoor. Which reminds me, an eyewitness just failed to identify Cagney McCleary. You have to release him. Now.
Well, at first I thought my eyes were deceiving me when I saw those pictures Brett took of you and Jonas.
Oh, has he developed them already?
Brought the first to the studio. They are so gorgeous, they almost don't look real. I mean, that's why I had to come by here. I just wanted to be sure for myself that it wasn't a camera trick.
Was it?
No, Jonah really is the world's most beautiful baby, and you really are the world's most beautiful mother.
You know, you would have been in a lot of trouble if you said anything else.
Yeah, I'm aware of that.
Mm-hmm. Hello. Okay, we'll give Brett a little credit.
Those are my sentiments, exactly. That's why I asked him to meet me here tonight. I planned a business dinner to discuss the possibility of him becoming a publicist for Knights of the Turntable.
That sounds like a smart move. You know, he's bright and personable.
And he's your age.
What?
Susie, dear, I need a big favor from you.
What are you talking about?
Please take my place tonight. I have another appointment, which I cannot break, but this discussion with Brett is very important, and I just don't want to put it off.
Stephanie, I don't work for Channel 6 anymore. I would not
be
any
creative woman with the talent to back it up. I mean, look at the way you marketed your choice. Besides, you were the best employee Channel 6 ever had.
Thank you, but I don't...
You know the TV business, you understand the function of a publicist, and you understand this show. I couldn't ask for anything more.
No, you could ask for less. I wish I could help, but I wouldn't be very good company tonight. I'm really worried about Cagney.
Well, then my request should come as a double blessing. It'll take your mind off things.
Even if I could go, I can't leave Jonah.
I can stay here till Joe arrives.
What about your other appointment?
Let me get that for you, dear.
Stephanie, I really don't want to go.
Good morning, Susie. Well, now, what a lovely surprise. In addition to everything else, the man is punctual. Isn't this
beautiful? Susie, isn't this beautiful?
Very.
I should have brought two.
No. Susie can have mine.
No, really, you can.
Please. It's the least I can do. Brett, something has come up. I have another appointment, and Susie has very graciously offered to take my place at dinner, if that's all right with you.
Oh, of course.
Good. Now, I've made the reservations at Ernesto's, and since it is a business meeting, just instruct them to put the bill on my account.
Well, that's very kind of you, Mrs. Wyatt, but I take pride in settling on my own account.
Huh.
Are you ready?
Now, don't worry about Jonah, dear. He'll sleep right through the night. He won't even realize that you've left.
Oh, you'll need this over your shoulders. May I?
Yes.
It's getting cool outside.
Thank you. Enjoy yourself.
Okay, Cagney, get out of here. You're wearing out the floorboards.
What are you saying? I'm released?
For now, yeah.
What happened? What changed your mind?
Officer Adamson here. Call it a witness.
A guy named Gainey Muldoor.
I don't know him.
Well, he
he doesn't know you either. That's why you're being released. You see, Mr. Muldoor works at the rental agency that leased the van that was used in the robbery. He wrote out the rental agreement.
Wait, how could he clear me if my signature was on that paper?
Muldoor is an eyewitness. We had him take a look at you from the other side of that mirror there. He says you're not the one who rented the van.
I told you that hours ago, Lieutenant.
Look, Cagney, we have a bank teller who says that you signed for a $20,000 payroll.
Yes, I told you that, too.
And I'm telling you that we can't end this investigation until we find that money, so don't leave Henderson, okay?
If I wanted to leave Henderson, I would have done it already. Why don't you stop hassling me and go find Sam Evans? How about that?
Take him home, Mr. Adamson. Let's go.
I hate jumping down his throat like that, but this is just like a bad dream, you know? I'm still awake, and it's just happening.
Come on, let's blow this joint. You'll feel a whole lot better when you do.
I'm glad you found that guy.
Me too. I told your mother everything would all work out.
Thanks. I better give her a call right now. I'm sure she's wondering. I better call Susie, too, because I know she's worried about me.
Okay, I'll wait outside.
Thanks.
Is this her?
Mm-hmm. Uh-huh.
Yeah. What about this?
Yeah, give me a break, will you?
The pain come in waves?
Yeah, my whole stomach cramps up. What do you think it is, food poisoning?
Stomach flu.
It's rampant right now. 27 inmates in the same condition.
Mm-hmm. You got anything to give me for it?
Give this a try. These paint materials don't help matters either. And the fumes just serve to aggravate the symptoms. I've complained to maintenance, but they don't seem to care. I mean, one doctor, two medical trustees for 700 inmates. Mm. I've had 27 cases of hospitalized flu victims. One hepatitis victim, three cardiac arrests. A deliberate health hazard, and they wonder why the infirmary is overcrowded. Not even the height of flu season yet. Can hardly wait. Now, the only thing they do right around here, laundry. Stomach still won't settle. I'll give it a while. Takes about 20 minutes.
Doc, we need you in the ward. Patient 5 is having an attack. Can't breathe.
Finish that.
Yeah.
Lie still. I'll be right back.
Everything I'm doing is for us. We're Turners. We were cheated out of PI. Now it's my responsibility to get it back.
I don't want it. How many times do I have to tell you that?
We made a pact, remember? Cord and Victoria against the world. No one will ever separate us.
No one ever has.
Open your eyes, Victoria. Our enemy is closing in. This is the toughest struggle of my life, but I can win it if you stick by me.
No. This obsession will destroy you.
Impossible. When I'm with you, I feel like I'm invincible.
Don't say that. We all have our breaking points. That's why you must give up this pursuit at once.
I will. The minute you get some dirt on Kentucky Bluebird, it's the weapon that will get T.I. in my hands.
What you're asking is not only unreasonable, it's impossible.
It's not impossible. You're my sister. Your loyalty belongs to me.
It has nothing to do with loyalty. I don't even know this man. There's no way I can get the information that you want.
You have to. He's undermining my authority. He's turning Liza against me, and he won't stop until he's kicked me out of T.I. Don't you understand? It's a takeover. They're trying to push me out. I've got to keep alert. I've got to stay awake for a sneak attack. He's trying to take me down, but I can't let him.
Cord, this is the first chance we've had to get together since I left the hospital. I was hoping that we could talk about something else.
There's nothing else. Nothing else, T.I. is my life. I thought that you understood what it meant for both of us.
Nothing I say makes any difference. I can't reach you. Why, Cord? You're my brother.
You're on their side, aren't you? Liza? Kentucky? Looks like I'm outnumbered, doesn't it? Well, we'll see about that. Now who's in the dark?
Listen to what you're saying. Your obsession with T.I. is making you paranoid. You're behaving like someone who's out of touch with...
What? Determined to take what's his.
You ask me to help you? Then listen to me. All the scheming and plotting to take over T.I., it's going to backfire. You're the one who's going to get hurt. I'm a doctor. I know what I'm talking about. Do you hear what I'm saying? Do you?
Need a phone that sounds like a fire alarm. Hello?
Joe.
No, this is Stephanie Wyatt.
Stephanie? Well, this is Cagney. I'd like to speak
to... Cagney, what a surprise. I didn't realize they equipped jail cells with phones.
Is Susie there? I was hoping to speak with her.
I'm sure hope springs eternal where you are.
Listen, for your information, I've already been released. Now, could I please speak with Susie?
Why, I'm afraid that's impossible.
Is she with Jonah?
No, actually, Susie went out to dinner.
With Joe?
No, friend, I'm afraid the name escapes me.
However, if you're that eager to see her, you might be able to track her down. I think I recall she said something about Ernesto's.
Well, thank you.
My pleasure. Arrivederci, Cagney.
Another plus for Henderson.
Excuse me?
The restaurants, they're wonderful. Can't complain about the florists either. They had roses in every color you can imagine. I don't know why I picked red.
Well, red is always nice.
If I'd known I was taking you to dinner instead of Mrs. Wyatt, I would have picked up something else. I saw one that was unusual. A very soft pink.
Ballerina pink.
Right. How'd you know the name?
I'm familiar with the color.
Anyway, Henderson seems like a really great town.
Yes.
I would have liked growing up here.
I think Jonah will, too.
Speaking of Jonah... I thought you'd like to see the proofs.
Oh, Stephanie says you're an excellent photographer.
Well, I hope you're of the same opinion.
Oh, these are nice.
Well, he's an incredible baby. Look at the way he photographs. Oh, I could print every one of these. And it's not just his good looks, either. He's responsive. And that smile is a knockout.
Yes.
Well, he's got a performer's instinct if I've ever seen one. Sometimes it's inherited. Are you sure there's no grease paint somewhere in your pot?
No, just a little rosin.
Well, isn't that what dancers use?
Yes, gives you a sure footing.
Ballerina pink. Toe shoes, tutus, the whole number.
Swan wings, too.
Oh, I bet you were great.
Well, there was a point in my life when I wanted to be a ballerina more than anything else in the world.
My instincts are always right. This calls for a toast to the Swan Queen. Whose little duckling has a smile that could rival rubber bits.
Well, you're forgetting one thing. Jonah has no teeth.
Well, makes his accomplishments even more astounding, don't you think?
Ah.